2 weeks ago, we started our journey together. We've been looking at functions and limits. We've mostly been asking, what's the output value if the input is close to, but not at, a particular point? That's one way to get information about a function. That's a limit. This week, in week three, we're going to look at a different way to get some information about a function, a more active perspective on functions. Instead of just asking about an output value, I'm going to ask how changing the input affects the output, sort of a more active way to get information about a function, changing one thing affecting something else. This sort of situation comes up throughout our lives. There's some function whose input is money and whose output is how much coffee I'm drinking. Some change to the amount of money that I'm making will affect how much coffee I'm drinking. And it keeps going, right? If I take one more sip of coffee, I'll be slightly more alert. There's some function whose input is coffee and whose output is alertness. Some small change to my coffee will affect how alert I am. These kinds of relationships, one thing changing affecting something else, pervade life, pervade science. We want to understand them systematically, and that's what the derivative offers us. This idea is so important that we're going to be spending 2 months on this topic. We're going to be studying derivatives numerically, algebraically, geometrically. But our journey begins right now, in week three, the derivative.